Then She Found Me by Elinor Lipman, narrated by Mia Barron.
Chapter 1. My biological mother was 17 when she had me in 1952, and even that was more than I wanted to know about her. I had no romantic notions about the coupling that had produced me. Not about her being cheerleader to his football captain or au pair to his Rockefeller. When I thought about it at all, this is what I imagined. Two faceless and cheap teenagers doing it listlessly in the unfinished basement where they jitterbugged unchaperoned. Adopted was never a label that made me flinch. Its meaning within our family was hand-selected, star-crossed, precious. I loved the story of my parents' first glimpse of me at the agency, how I solemnly studied their faces, hers, his, back to hers, then grinned. I was raised to be glad that the unlucky teenage girl couldn't keep me. The last thing I wanted was some stranger for a mother. Still, I slept with a light on in my bedroom until I was 12, afraid she'd exercise her rights. Later, it annoyed me. The teenage girl annoyed me, nothing more. Could she ever have worn real maternity clothes or taken a single prenatal vitamin on my behalf? Here is where I remember to feel relief and gratitude and say, no matter. I am healthy, happy, better off. It is a lucky thing she didn't keep me. I'd barely have finished high school. I'd have become a beautician or a licensed practical nurse, and I would think I had a glamorous career. The grittier I made it, the more righteous I felt. I invented these jitterbugging teenagers when I was in junior high school, as my adoptive parents began to look old. I voted against the irresponsible kids, emphatically for the Epners. My story suited me, and I grew to believe it. I did not attend support groups for adoptees, and I did not search for anyone. Then she found me. Chapter 2. A Boston Globe staff photographer took the picture on a sunny Sunday. "One more time," read the headline. "April Epner, 3½, makes her displeasure known as swan boat ride, first of the season, ends. Parents Gertrude and Julius Epner of Providence promise another." In ponytails and clutching a miniature pocketbook to my chest, I howl adorably. Trudy and Julius smile at each other over my beretted head. The smile of doting parents whose Sunday outing has succeeded beyond their fondest hopes. Wire services picked up the Globe photo and sent it out on the National Wire with a new headline: "Make Way for Ducts." It was used by newspapers all over New England and in odd spots where harbinger of spring photos were in short supply. Julius wrote to the Globe's photo librarian expressing his interest in a glossy print, which he matted and framed alongside its grainy newsprint twin. In downtown Boston, Bernice Graverman passed the brass plaque that read, "Florence Cone Agency," on a lunch hour excursion. She thought, "It's fate that made me get off the trolley at Boylston. I didn't mean to, but now that I'm here, I must go up." She was pleased with the way she looked that day in her camel's hair coat from the store's Washington's birthday sale, and she had good news. She checked her brown page boy, her lipstick, and the seams in her stockings before taking the elevator to the 4th floor. "Is Mrs. Prince here?" she asked the receptionist. "There's no one here by that name," she was told. "Yes, there is," said Bernice. "She was my social worker, and it wasn't that long ago." She touched her stomach. 100 sit-ups a day, as flat as ever. The receptionist frowned and retreated.
"You mean Mrs. Price?"
"Isn't that what I said?"
"She's no longer here."
"Did she get fired?" the girl asked. The receptionist pursed her lips and asked for Bernice's name at the time of her association with the Florence Cone Agency. She opened a dark wood door and passed through into inner offices. After several minutes, an impeccable-looking woman in cream-colored wool followed the receptionist back to the waiting room. The woman offered her hand.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.